In this video, I'll show you how to add audio or voiceover narration to Google Slides. Hi, my name is David, and if this is your first time watching my videos and you get value from the content that you watch, kindly consider liking this video and sharing it with your friends so that we can all learn together. By default, Google Slides doesn't support recording audio narration to your slides right on the fly, like you can do it inside Microsoft PowerPoint. Therefore, you need to record your audio off Google Slides and then upload your audio to Google Drive. In a previous tutorial, I walked you through the process of recording and editing an audio narration inside Audacity, a free and open source audio editing application. Therefore, if you haven't watched that tutorial, kindly go and check it out, where I walk you through the configuration of the mic to recording and editing your audio. Now, since we've already done that, what we need to do now is add our audio to our slides. Now, for this to work, you need to have your audio inside Google Drive. So where we're going to begin, by uploading our audio to Google Drive and then importing it or inserting it to our slides or the slide that we need the audio to be. So let's begin by going to drive.google.com. And once I click on that, it's going to open up our drive. Please note that some sections of this particular drive interface are slightly blurred because of some sensitive information. Now let's begin by clicking on new folder. It's always good to keep your files in sync or in the same folder. Let's call it this folder something like, let's say, Google Slides presentation one. Just click on create. And once you click on create, the new folder is going to open up. The number one thing that I might begin off with is by right clicking and clicking on share this particular Google Drive folder. And the reason for that is because I want to make sure that anyone with a link to this particular folder can see the files. Also, when you share your Google Slide presentation, people don't get an error when they try to play the audio. So just come to change to anyone with a link, and here's your link, and click on done. Once you finish that, we can just double click on this particular folder, and all we need to do is just drag and drop our audio inside this new folder. Let's just come to the folder with the slide, with a particular audio, and then just drag and drop it inside there. Once we do that, depending on the length of your audio, the strength of your connection, it may take a long or a short time, but since this is a short file, it just uploaded in just a couple of seconds. Now, once this is done, let's go back to Google Slides, and let's say the narration that we just added, slide one for Google Drive, let's say it's for this particular slide. So what do we need to do? With the slide selected, just come to insert, audio, and the options to insert audio include from my drive, shared with me, let's say by a client, or even recent files. You also have the option to search for the particular audio if you know the exact title or name of that particular audio. And these are the options to see what type of views or sorting that you may have for your files. For example, this particular audio that we just added is this particular audio, slide one for Google Drive. Just click on it and then click on select. And once we click on select, it's going to start creating audio. And here is our audio. It shows you an audio icon and a play button and the length of the audio. And you can also see it or open it in Google Drive. To the right, a couple of format options. The audio playback tab here shows us it's going to start playing on click automatically. Also the volume while presenting. You can hide icon when presenting, loop audio, stop on slide change. Really depends on what you're going for. Let's say you want to automate this particular process, or let's say you wanted to record your Google Slide presentation using an application like OBS. Then what you can do is that you can click automatically or on click, really depending on how you're going to be navigating through your presentation. If you click on that, then you're going to get the option to hide the icon when presenting. But if it's on click, then you'll need to see the icon so that you can click on it for it to start playing. Let's say you want to make it automatically. And since we're not changing anything else here, we can just minimize that, the size and rotation. You can lock the aspect. Really depends on what adjustments you want to do. Let's say you want to make it bigger. Really depends on what you want to do. Let's press on Control Z to just get it back to the default size. And then you have the options for positioning, recolor. You can either change the color of the icon to whatever. Let's say we give it like this particular color. That's what it looks like. You can make any adjustments that you want for transparency, brightness, contrast, drop shadow if you want one. Not really interested. A reflection if you want one. Not really interested. The main option or format options that you can really work well with that will boost or keep your slides or presentation engaging, just include the audio playback section, whether to start playing on click or automatically. Now let's say it's automatically, and let's say we want to start presenting. Just click on that. And our audio by default,
welcome to this video. Presenting.
My name is David.
If by any chance you have press on the next slide,
then our presentation is going to stop. Our video is going to start off with it being mute, as we did in the previous tutorial on how to add video to Google Slides, and it's going to play automatically. Now, that tutorial has been in-depth on how you can add audio, voiceover, narration, or even if you wanted to add music to a slide inside Google Slides. I hope this video has been of value and that you've benefited from the content that you watch. Until next time, stay safe and never stop learning.